Welcome to Lawn Rush. In today's video, I want to talk about the Fisher XLS snow plow. I've had these plows on the trucks now for a number of years. This one I just picked up this year, but this one I've had since like 2019. And I actually switched over to Fisher from Western because I really wanted that stainless steel look with the silver truck. So I went ahead and went with Fisher. So since I started getting these plows, the price of these have gone up quite a bit. For this first one that I bought back in 2019, I paid like $7,000 for. And that was the plow, the controller, the mount, everything installed, all done, all in one shot. Now, on the other hand, for this plow I bought this year, it was used. I paid $6,800 for it. And it was just for the blade and the headgear. There was no controller, just the plow itself. Everything truck side was already on the truck, and it was $6,800. So just to put into perspective how much things have gone up, things have gone up quite a bit. And it was not even a new plow. It was used for one season, but very new condition, very, very new condition. So when I originally bought this new one here, I kept looking at it, because they were saying that it was only a year old. And once I got it home, I won't say buyer's remorse, but kind of sort of getting close to buyer's remorse, because like looking close, you could see like a little bit of rust in the corners there and stuff like that. And I'm thinking like, dang, I hope this plow really is pretty new. Like they said, it's kind of hard to say because I was comparing it to my old one that had a number of years on it. And I don't know, just certain things seemed maybe a little cleaner on this one. Maybe my maintenance is a little bit different than how theirs was. So they may have corrosion a little bit in different spots than I do. But definitely can tell, though, that the one that I picked up is newer. Now that I've had it running in all those different situations, it does seem to be newer. But going used, I do have a couple small issues. I think this ram's leaking. It's always looking kind of oily, and from time to time I am low on oil, so I think something's going on there. On this one, look how dry this is compared to how oily that one looks, so could be an issue there. I'm not sure, but something I'm definitely keeping an eye on. And what'll happen is it'll keep running, and the next thing you know, it'll get low on oil and it won't be able to extend to its fully extended mode, and it'll start starving oil, start getting air in the oil and not wanting to move and getting all squishy. And yeah, but all in all, I have to say, these Fisher stainless steels, they do hold up a little bit better than the Western variant without the stainless steel. How much longer they're going to last, it's kind of tough to say. I mean, because the Western whiteout that I had before this was showing like rust on the moldboards sooner. Now, the thing about stainless steel is it's just a moldboard. All this stuff back here is steel, mild steel. So you still have your corrosion points. Now, the weird thing about the Fishers compared to the Westerns is they have this stacking stop right here, and it cuts into this arm and it leaves a little wear mark. I don't know if that's going to shorten the life at all. It doesn't seem to be. As far as corrosion is concerned on this stuff, it's such heavy gauge that it's not a real concern. Now, one thing I did notice with this older one is the perches that hold the springs became warped on the outsides. Now, here's one that didn't get warped, and then here's one that did. And something happened in the last snowfall. I don't know if something got hit, something like a manhole cover or something got hit, because this one's bent and then this other one is bent. And when I looked at the plow, it was bare metal. It wasn't even starting to corrode. It's starting to corrode now, but whatever happened in the last snowfall. So I'm going to talk to the guys and see if they can let me know if they hit something hard. Nothing seems like broken on the plow, but I'm telling you, I've hit a lot of stuff hard and I've never noticed that warping. And I've even hit some pretty hard items or objects, manhole covers and things like that with this plow, and none of my spring perches are warped at all. So kind of curious to what was hit, but it doesn't seem to be anything structurally damaged on the plow. Just a little weird that happened. Now I have kind of kicked around the idea of selling this one. As we get close to the end of the season, I could get by with just the one plow on the 450 here. But at the same time, it is nice. I mean, it relieves me of a lot of stress to have the two plows. But I'm really in a good situation because if one of the plows were to break, I would still get done. Take me a little longer, but I would still get done. It's weird. It's like so much work is getting done by the second plow that it's really just helping me out so much. And then we're actually able to go out and help other companies as like a subcontractor, which I think is a good spot to be. You know, as you're a subcontractor doing work, you don't get as much money, but sometimes it can be cash. And sometimes, I mean, so let's say, for example, a plow breaks and I can't get to the subcontracting work. Well, it's subcontracting work and it's not the end of the world. It's not on me necessarily. I can always say, hey, I'm sorry, I can't get there. And it's just subcontract. It's not like my own contract, and I'm not honoring that my own contract. So that's definitely a huge help. But I've been kicking around the idea of selling this one because if I were to sell it, it would give me some cash to go into the spring season, and then I can worry about getting another new plow next year. So that's a thought, although the cost of a new one is going to be quite expensive. But also kind of kicked around the idea of putting this 8 to 10 XLS, sliding this one over to the F250, and then being the 450, throwing the XL plow on the 450. Which could be a good thing. I don't know. I like to haul my plow pretty much all season just so that I'm ready. I don't want to be trying to hook up a plow when you get some lake effect snow come out of nowhere and you got to get up and go. I don't want to be trying to hook up a plow at those times. It's like whenever there's snow on the ground, the plows don't even want to line up. Like if you park your plow, there's no snow, then you hook it up with snow and that snow gets up under the tires, it doesn't line up anymore. And there's a big problem trying to get hooked up. So I leave my plow hooked up, and if I go with an XLS XL, then that means more weight on the truck, which might not be such a good thing. I mean, it is a 450 and it handles this 1100 pound plow pretty good, but I don't know, that XL, it's tempting. There's some guys with some V plows with wings that outperform these XLSs, so it'd be interesting to have like a V plow with wings. But overall, these plows have held up great over the years. I've had very minimum problems. This one hit a car. Well, a car hit it. Actually, a car came up and clipped the end of the wing on the other side, actually. And this car, when it hit this wing, the doors, they came up from the side and they swiped the wing. And I think where you can see the paint's missing there. And the doors of the car, like the skin of the doors, got ripped off of the car. And the car is fine. I mean, no, the plow is fine. The car was jacked up. The car had the skin of its doors ripped off. It looked horrible. But the plow, the plow got like pushed and it blew out a hose. And we replaced the hose. I believe it was the other side hose that got blew out. We replaced the hose and it was good. After we placed that hose, that was it. And it barely did anything to the plow. So that was interesting situation. A little bit of a can opener situation with these plows, but that just goes to show how strong these are. This is the original cutting edge. It's starting to get low, but we still got enough maybe to finish this season. But guys, I've had good service from these plows. The way I use them, I don't really go through cutting edges a whole lot because our lots are small. We don't cover like a ton of miles or blade time down. We just hit small lots. But when we get some bigger stuff, you can tell that these wear. You can almost see it every storm. There's quite a bit more meat on here when it was new. But we've actually worn the bolts, as you can see on this one.
We're starting to get to the first bolt. That was that bolt was fully there at the start of the season. And this one is only down to two bolts, and that one's getting ready to pop out. So,
all in all, guys, these plows are great. I definitely think they're worth the money. The trip edge is superior, I think, over the trip board that you're getting a Western. But anyway, that's my time. It is 10 minutes here on the video. My name is Sean. This is Lawn Rush. See you guys in the next one. Over and out.